Hi guys, it's me, welcome back. I have, from the title, as you can see, a ginormous haul. I have no clue how I'm gonna get through all this stuff, so I'm thinking let's just get right into it. So, yesterday I went to Sephora, and a few weeks ago I placed an order on Look Fantastic. I don't know if you guys had the opportunity to check out the Christmas slash winter collections by Chanel, Dior, Lancome. Well, I've been watching some videos of girls who, you know, buy regularly all the new collections, and I must say, in my opinion, that the most beautiful collection was the collection by Dior. I think that Dior's Christmas collection was just so glamorous, so feminine, so beautiful, just, you know, over the top. That's all I have to say. So I bought some stuff from Dior, but before getting into the whole Dior atmosphere, I wanted to show you just a few things that I got from other brands, just three. First thing I got yesterday at Sephora was this perfume. This is what the bottle looks like. The bottle itself is so beautiful, so chic, so feminine. It's just lovely to keep it on your vanity, and the smell is I'm so bad in describing smell, so if I manage to find a description, I'll put it here somewhere. Lancome's Visionnaire Serum. I've been wanting to buy this for months and months and months, and I've been going on for the past few months. I've been using samples. Every time I would go to a beauty store and the sales associate would ask me, is there something you want to try? I would say yes, give me a little sample or whatever you have of Lancome's Visionnaire, because I love this serum, but boy is this expensive. This is the most expensive makeup item or cosmetics item in general I own. This is the 100ml and I paid more than 100 euro for this alone, and it is so expensive. This stuff better last me a year, seriously, or at least 10 months. The reason why I really, really wanted to have this is because Ray from Rayview here on YouTube, which is a person that I love and I trust her opinion and her judgment 100%, uses this in her like daily skincare routine, and she loves it. She swears by it. She says that she has seen some results in her skin, and so I trust her vision. I've been using, as I said, testers and samples for the past few months, and I like it. It works good with my skin. It's a skin corrector for wrinkles, pores, and it makes your skin color basically more even. So if you have stuff like hyperpigmentation or spots, I mean, not spots in terms of pimples, but spots that, you know, scars here and there, then this would definitely help. I haven't seen some drastic results yet. I think it's way too early, but I'm really, really hoping that from now to maybe a couple of months, I will see some improvements in my skin. I will let you know. And then I decided to buy this eyeliner by YSL. It's in their YSL Shocking line, and it is their Bold Felt Tip Eyeliner Pen. And this is how it looks like. I got it in black, obviously. And the reason why I decided to buy this is because I've absolutely been loving my Dolly Wink eyeliner pen. It's amazing. I love it. I'm already panicking on how I'm gonna manage when that finishes. Anyway, I decided to give this one a go, because I'm hoping that it will be a good substitute. This is what it looks like. And this is the tip. I'm using it today, and I must say, not bad. Not bad at all. So yeah, now we can start with all the Dior stuff I got. Oh my god, really, Mr. Dior should give me a prize for all the money I've given him this month. I really, really splurged. So let's get started. The first two things I got from Dior are these two lip liners. Now, the person to blame for these two products is my dearest friend here on YouTube, LisaLisaD1. She raves about Dior's lip liners. I already have a Dior lip liner in the color Earth, or terracotta, and I love that so much, and I decided to give these two a try. And the colors I picked are linen and candy rose. So linen is this one over here. As you can see, it is a very neutral brownish lip liner, which I feel will work great with all my neutral lipsticks. And then Candy Rose is this beautiful, I totally understand why they call this Candy Rose, because it is a rosy lip liner. And I'm wearing it now, and this stuff looks really, really great with any cherry, red, pink lipstick you have. It'll work great with so, so many different colors. Now I'm wearing my YSL Lip Stain in the color 13, which is a bright fuchsia color. And I'm wearing this with it, and it works great. As you can see, I absolutely love it. Then also by Dior, I picked up their concealer. And I was I didn't know which concealer to get, whether to get this one or their new concealers from the Nude line. But the sales associate told me that this one over here has more coverage in comparison to the Nude concealers. So I got this one over here, Dior Skin Sculpt in the color 002 Beige. They have three colors, a light, a medium, and a dark color, and this is the medium color. And it has a doe foot applicator, and I'm wearing it today, and I can say that yes, this stuff really, really covers. Then from the Christmas collection, I picked up their lipsticks. Oh, did you see the packaging of the lipsticks? It's just so glamorous and beautiful, like old Hollywood. I mean, I wish I could have all of them. I picked up the lipstick in 038 Diva, and their nail varnish in 011 Lady. And all the items from the Christmas collection are packaged in these beautiful golden boxes. Ah, it's all about the details. Look at that. Have you ever seen such a beautiful lipstick packaging? I mean, I can already see this in my handbag. And then I want to reapply my lipstick, and I just take this out and go, love it. It's just fantastic. And this is the color Diva. Red all the way, because everybody's wearing red, everybody looks great in red, so I absolutely wanted to have a red lipstick. And I must say, choosing between all the new lipsticks in the new collection was kind of difficult, because I have no clue which kind of red looks good of me. I think this is a red with a blue undertone, but there are reds with a more pink undertone. There's, I think, Hollywood or Marilyn, which is a more orangey red. They all look beautiful, but I would need to try all of them on my lips to see which one looks good. But I think this one has potential. What do you think? Anyway, I'm gonna wear it and I'm gonna love it. And then this is the nail varnish I picked up. And unfortunately, the nail varnishes were all almost out. They only had this one over here and the golden nail varnish. So between the two, I decided to go for this one, because I do not have a white nail varnish in my collection. And I thought that this would look very pretty with like a glittery top coat on top, something like that. So yeah, I mean, look at the bottle. It's so cute. And then, last but not least, I decided to pick up two eyeshadow palettes. This one over here is called Night Goals, and it is one of the two eyeshadow palettes of their Christmas collections. They are both beautiful, gorgeous, but I decided to go for this one because Ruth from A Model Recommends, which I love, owns this palette, and she recently did a kind of makeup favorites or makeup routine in which she showed how she applied these eyeshadows on her face, on her eyes obviously, and she made it look also simple and also easy, and the final result was beautiful, awesome, very glittery, very shiny, very Christmassy. So I thought, well, I need that. This is what the palette looks like from the outside. So shiny. This palette is such a beautiful palette because the colors are basically neutral colors. You have your taupe, you have your beigey color, you have your white highlighter. Then there's that in the middle crease color for the extra definition that we all like. And you could play with all these colors so easily and the result would be awesome. I mean, when Ruth applied these eyeshadows, she was mixing and matching and the result was perfect. I mean, it's so easy. And then I've always wanted to try these three colors smoky palettes. And the one I got is this one over here, 481 in Smoky Khaki. And yeah, I saw these three color smoky eye palettes in one of Ruth's vlogs. I mean, she's the one to blame for all these Dior products. Anyway, she used this in one of her vlogs in which she was traveling to Paris. And that's such a genius idea because these palettes are small and compact, but they have three colors and it's ideal for when you travel, really. And these are the colors. They are very neutral, like the other palette. I decided to go for all neutrals because Dior's neutral palettes are just amazing. So you have your base color over here and then two crease colors at the bottom and you can mix and match. And I feel that however you match and mix these colors, the result will be flawless. I can't wait to use this. Like, you know, in the morning when you're in a rush and you don't know what eyeshadow, if you want to wear eyeshadow, and you don't really want to stay there and think about different combinations and different colors, just take one of these palettes out, especially these little three ones, and you have everything there. You don't have to think, you just slap them on and you look good. Then last but not least, I really, really, really wanted to show you this purchase that I made 2 weeks ago. I was a naughty girl. I should not have bought this, but I just could not resist. Like it always happens, I cannot resist. So a few weeks ago, I was watching a video with Fleur and Nikki, Fleur the Force and Nikki Philippi here on YouTube, in which they were both showing what was in their travel makeup bag. I love those kinds of videos because in my opinion, what people carry in their travel makeup bag is the products that they really, really rely on, that they really like, and that really work for them. You know what I mean? So for me, if you decide to carry something in your makeup bag, it's because you trust that product and you know that it's gonna work with you. It's gonna work for you. In this video, Fleur de Force showed her makeup bag, obviously. And when she showed it, I was like, I want that now. She mentioned this makeup bag by a designer that I must say I haven't really heard of before that. And her name is Anya Hindmarch, who is a British fashion designer. She specializes in accessories and all things for traveling. I mean, seriously, when you go on her website, be strong with a lot of self-control because all the stuff there is amazing. Anyway, I went straight to her makeup bag collections and this is the one I picked out. Oh my god! Can you see how beautiful it is? Seriously, this is a piece of art. I will not buy another makeup bag for the rest of my life. Seriously, if I do, you can punish me, really. Because this was so expensive. I mean, I really, if I go and buy another makeup bag, something's wrong with me. I paid a ton, but it is beautiful. Just the details, girl. Look at the details. It has two compartments. This is the top compartment. As you can see, it has a section for brushes and a little zip pocket over there, which will come in so handy for jewelry and stuff. And I love it because this means that you can carry brushes and makeup all in one pouch. And that is just so convenient. And then down here you have your makeup section. It is very spacious, so you can fit quite a lot of stuff in here. And it is great. It is made of this very washable material. So even if you stain it, I'm sure you could wash it with a damp or wet cloth. And yeah, that's it. These are the zip tassels over here, so beautiful. All the hardware is gold and it says makeup in front, and I just love that it says makeup in front. It's just so pretty. So yeah, girls, this is all the damage that was made in the month of November. Lots of Dior, lots of skincare, makeup bag, can't wait to go on holiday again so I can use it. Anyway, thank you so much for watching. Please comment, please subscribe, please thumbs up. And let me know if you checked out some of the winter/Christmas collections. Let me know which one is your favorite. I really, really liked the Chanel Christmas collection, but unfortunately when I went to Sephora, everything was out. What I really, really hope to get my hands on is the lipstick. I mean, that lipstick is so vampy, it's so dark. I absolutely want that. And I really hope I manage to find it. And thanks for watching again, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye, girls.